Gremlin is the world's leading enterprise reliability platform, and now we're making it easier than ever to ensure reliability on the world's leading cloud platform, AWS. In the next 5 minutes, you'll learn how to deploy Gremlin to your AWS environment, how to authenticate Gremlin with AWS, how to detect services running in your environment, and how to run reliability tests on those services in just a few clicks. You'll also get a look at our intelligent health checks feature and our automatic risk detection process, which finds AWS specific reliability risks just by seeing how your services are configured. Let's start on Gremlin's Getting Started page. When you first log into Gremlin, this is the page you'll see. This isn't just a checklist though, it's a fully interactive guide to getting up and running. The very first thing you'll need to do is install the Gremlin agent into your AWS environment. If you're on EKS, you can use our Helm chart or Kubernetes manifest. If you're on EC2, we provide packages for Amazon Linux and other distributions. If you're on Lambda, you can use failure flags to embed Gremlin right into your serverless functions, but that's a topic for a different video. For now, I have the Gremlin agent running on an EC2 host, and it's reporting in as healthy. What we're really interested in is step three, defining your services. Gremlin asks where your services are running, whether they're in AWS or somewhere else. Of course, we'll keep AWS selected, then scroll down to see the various options. Gremlin lets you set up multiple AWS accounts and uses the account ID to identify them. We're starting from scratch, so Gremlin asks me how I want to authenticate with AWS. The default and recommended method is to use IAM and CloudFormation. The reason behind this two-step approach is so Gremlin can automatically detect services that are mapped to load balancers. This lets us monitor the health of your services so that we can stop tests if your services become unhealthy. And it also lets us detect potential misconfigurations that could lead to bigger reliability problems. Gremlin requests read-only permissions for a limited number of services and actions. If you want to see the full list of permissions required, you can click Manual and we'll show you the entire policy. We get that you might need to do a security review before using this feature, so we also have a link to our documentation explaining where and how this policy is being used. Back to the Getting Started guide. Assuming you're an IAM administrator and you've already got the green light from your security team, just click Launch Stack. Gremlin will open a new tab in AWS with our CloudFormation stack template pre-selected. We also explain what the stack does in the description. You can give it a different name if you'd like, or keep the default. The customer company ID is the ID assigned to your company in Gremlin. We automatically fill this in for you, but in the rare instance this field is blank, you can just copy your ID from the Gremlin web app into this field. You can find it in the bottom left corner of any screen under your username and team ID. Check the box to confirm that CloudFormation can create roles with custom names, then click Create Stack. AWS will apply the template, create the rules, and return a role ARN. Copy this ARN back into the Gremlin web app, click Save, and that's it. The authentication process is done. The next step is to add our services. Remember that Gremlin identifies your ELBs, and we can match them to the host and containers that the Gremlin agent detected. If there's a match, we automatically map them for you. So for instance, I have an EC2 instance running a web server, and I have an ELB that points to that instance. Gremlin already knows I have an EC2 instance because I have an agent installed on it. And now, Gremlin also knows that I have an ELB pointing to that instance. I just need to check the box next to the ELB, click Create Service, and just like that, Gremlin has created a page with details about my service, a full suite of tests to run, and it even detected reliability risks without me having to run a single test. One more thing, Gremlin supports different collections of reliability tests, which we call test suites. The default Gremlin test suite is built around common failure modes across all environments, but we also have a test suite built specifically for cloud environments. This is our well-architected cloud test suite. This will replace the current set of reliability tests for all services in our team with the tests in this suite. Gremlin will save all of our test scores and notes, though, so if we do decide to switch back at a later time, we can pick up right where we left off. So now I'll head back to the service and we can start testing. Now that we've got our service defined and our health checks added, we can start running reliability tests. This is the easy part. Just find the test you want to run, click Run, and confirm. Gremlin will distribute the test out to the target system, and we'll start monitoring CloudWatch at the same time. We can track the test progress on our end too. This chart shows the status of our health checks during the test, and the test progression section shows which experiments are currently active. We can see whether any of our health checks have returned a pass or fail, and we can watch real-time logs streaming in from the agent during the test. For now, let's skip ahead to the end of the test.
So the results of our test are in. Unfortunately, we failed our disk IO test. In this case, the error rate check detected errors on our ELB. This tells us that our service can't tolerate heavy sustained disk IO. It gives us a clear direction on where we need to improve our AWS environment and workloads. So, we've authenticated our AWS account, we've installed our agent, we detected our ELBs, we created our services, we ran our first tests, and we got our detected risks. Let's run some more tests, build up our score, and start improving our reliability so we can make our AWS environment even better. Now that you've seen how easy it is to test the reliability of your AWS services using Gremlin, why not give it a try? You can sign up for a free, no-risk, 30-day trial by going to gremlin.com/trial.